Well, hello there. Here we are on Monday, the 9th of September, 2019, at 8:23 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. And at the moment, we have Jupiter and Antares are showing, Saturn, and the moon is over to the left behind that willow tree over there. You can see it peeking through there. But anyway, at the moment, I'm on the Canon 80D with the 17-55 Canon lens on there. It's an f2.8, and I was just out taking pictures, and it's a bit too early yet. And I was hoping to shoot for the Milky Way, but with that moon, I don't think we're going to be able to. It's about 85% lit, so it's not the best time to do it. But we take what we can get whenever we can. And if we use this footage, we're going to see a airplane down there heading towards willow trees down below Saturn. So that's what that blinking light is, just so you know. Now, I can't really do much else right at the moment. Not with this lens, because I do believe... Oh, okay, no, we're not zoomed in all the way. On the 17-55. But the bright object there to the right of the willow tree is Saturn. And the stars of Sagittarius are out and about around it. Okay, and we're recording this onto the Atomos Ninja Flame just to get a bit of background here. I might try to use this as a background for the video from the Nikon P1000 if I go in the house and go get it. Okay, so the brighter star there in the middle is Jupiter. Down below in the bottom right is Antares. And again, that's as far as we can zoom in on this Canon lens, 55 millimeters. And from there, we're going to have this take us over to M8, the Lagoon Nebula, but you can't really see it on here. Not with the equipment I have, but that's okay. We get what we can. And pretty much what we're seeing on the monitor here, if it translates the same once we go in the house and look on the computer, all I can see by eye is Antares and Jupiter. Saturn, and through the willow tree, the portion of the moon, and that's all I see here on the video portion on the Canon. But anyway, I'm going to get back to taking some pictures. It's gotten a little bit darker out, so I hope to be back soon. Okay, we're back out now with the Nikon P1000 camera. And what's really strange is I can't see Europa on here. Europa should be to the right of Jupiter. Then Ganymede and Io are the two on the left side, and Callisto far off to the top left there. And I have the ISO up really high, so if we can get Callisto in, we should be able to get Europa. So I don't know what happened to it here. I will try to take a clip and I'll be right back. Just a second. Or two. Alrighty, I figured out what happened to Europa. When I looked earlier, before I came out, Europa was further away, about the 5 o'clock position. And as time has gone on, it's gotten closer to the planet, so you can't really see it here. But it's still about the 5 o'clock position, apparently. Anyway, that should do it for those guys. I'm going to change up so we can get a look at Jupiter. Well, you know. Sorry about that. I didn't have it zoomed in all the way. Quite often I can't get all four moons in when they're spread apart so much. So I tend to leave it back further. But you know what? I'm going to get a clip with it zoomed in like this. So we're going to try this all over again. Ah, cool. It looks like we have the great red spot over there in the bottom left tonight. That's quite cool. Okay, there we go. We should have had our clip if I remember to turn the record on and off. We shall see. So if I'm able to stack the images and it comes out kind of halfway decent, we'll include that in here right next to the video portion. But that's good enough for the planet over in the southwest sky. And so from Jupiter, we're going to head over to Saturn. It's next to 9 here. It'll take me a few moments to get it all centered in here. There we go. Oh, it looks like it's coming in pretty good tonight. Pretty yellow. Oh yeah, it looks like it's coming out pretty nice. Earlier when we were taking pictures with the other camera, we had all kinds of things photobombing the sky. I think at one point when I was trying to get a shot of the M8 Lagoon Nebula, there was a satellite that was zipping on down, and then just a bare second later there was an airplane cutting across, and so you can see the difference in between the two of them, between what a satellite looks like on a long exposure shot and what an airplane looks like, the streaks that they make. So the airplane's going to be more segmented and the satellite's going to be more of a solid white line. But yeah, Saturn is coming out very, very nicely. We shall take it. But from there, over to the left of it now, on the opposite side from the other night when we got it, it's going to be our 85% moon. We got all our clips of planets and moons, and now we can finish up with old Luna here. Oh my, our noisy neighborhood at it again. Anyway, we're starting down here zoomed in at the southern part of the moon, and if you recall what I mentioned the other night about the Indian mission to the moon, how they, I'll wait till they pass. Yeah, a few days ago, the Indian mission to the Mars, a few days ago, India had sent a mission to the moon, and everything seemed to be going okay there until it got like 2 kilometers away from the surface, and then they lost contact with the lander. And so apparently it had a hard landing, I call that a crash. And I do believe it was yesterday that they located the lander, but there's still no communication with it, so it's down around here somewhere. Good on them for all the hard work that they did. I know it must have been so disappointing, but boy, that does not look good, does it? My gosh. I don't know what's up with this. The moon should be coming in really clear. Especially one of my favorite areas over here that I call the boneyard. Well, I guess that's going to have to do. There must be something up in my atmosphere over here. Some gunk. Okay, there's our light beam area. Question mark. Oh, that good stuff. Whoa. Cool flyby down there. Probably a bat, I'm guessing. Alrighty, there we go, in this start of the new week here. So I hope wherever you are, everything's going all right and all is right in your world. See y'all, take care now. Goodbye from Northeastern Ohio. And it's now 9:33 p.m. A very good night to you. Bye now.